So hello, I am in Jaipur. Jaipur is the capital of Rajasthan. It is one of the three tourist cities in North India. They talk about tourists in North India doing Delhi, Agra, Jaipur, that Golden Triangle they call it. And it's kind of because of that that I sort of reluctantly added it to my trip. I'm trollishly avoiding some of the well-known, iconic India vacation moments, because I'm like that. So, but I'm finding that Jaipur's kind of fun. It's a large city. It's got a lot of modern conveniences. My hotel has internet that works. I know, I'm an addict to the internet. But it's also, you know, friendly people and interesting sites. I have since, you know, I have taken to in the more tourist-centered cities, realizing that I need to use what I call the Vamp Willow approach. Buffy the Vampire Slayer fans will get why I call it this. It does not involve breaking fingers, but it does involve telling a cab driver, or asking a cab driver, who do you work for, enough times that until they say, I work for you, you are working for me. I say this when they say, oh, you don't want to go there. There's a better market I can take you to. You want to go to Khan Market? Why? I'll take you to a better market. I just say, who do you work for? You work for me. And when the boss gets in the car and says, take me to Khan Market, you take me to Khan Market. And gets the point across. It lets them know that that I know what they are doing when they try to take me to some place that I didn't ask to be taken, and that I'm aware of the places I'm asking to go enough to have something to say about them. So I don't know if I've explained this before, if this is kind of clear, but there are commission shops that there are, you know, there are stores that work as regular stores do. They're government-sponsored stores as well. But then there are stores that kind of work off the legitimate grid, and they raise their prices and sell primarily to tourists. And they can do this because taxi drivers will take people to them. And taxi drivers will take people to them because they pay, from what I understand, a flat rate. I think I mentioned this with the hotels before, but the stores that do this as well, yeah, pay a flat rate. In Varanasi, one of the honest dealers. Now I'm pretty sure this guy was honest. Told me that these other stores pay 100 rupees for dropping off a tourist there, regardless of whether the tourist bought anything. So the taxi driver would say, well, I'll take you to this very nice store, very good silk, very fine souvenirs, and very cheap price. And they'll get 100 rupees. You know, they'll take you there and take you back, and they'll get 100 rupees regardless of whether you spend anything. And the people at the stores that I've seen in other cities have been pushing the hard sell, but kind of gracious. I guess, you know, they offer tea and they have a pleasant attitude. So after telling, you know, I wanted to go to a particular store called Fab India, and then after telling the driver, you work for me, and I say I want to go to Fab India, because he was saying, oh, there are better places to shop. For one, how you're dressed, you don't want to tell me where to shop. And for two, the boss says we're going to Fab India. So he took me there, and I racked up a nice Fab India bill. We'll have to see if you can order this stuff in the U.S. because it's good stuff, but I'm sure it's more expensive shipped there. Anyway, Fab India. There's my product placement ad. After we left Fab India, I said, okay, we've agreed on a rate of 50 rupees an hour. If you take me back to the hotel now, it's only been 3 hours, but I will pay you 200 rupees. It was a little over 3 hours, anyway. Blah, blah, blah. I will pay you 200 rupees for the 4 hours, not quite, we spent sightseeing. If you take me to some janky souvenir shop and then take me back to the hotel, I will pay you 150. Essentially, I was saying to him that I would split the commission with him if it is 100, that I would get a 50 rupee discount on the day's trip, he would get a 50 rupee add-on. So he took that bait, and it's funny because when I first mentioned Fab India to him, he said, oh, that's very far away, very far, right? We need to go, you need to go to someplace closer. I said, no, I want to go to Fab India. I'm staying in Fab India. And then when we started going to the shop that he was on, it's like, where are we going? Because we were traveling a long, long way. So then we got there, and it was in a kind of residential neighborhood, and it took me kind of into the back of a building, and I saw it was like a factory room where rows upon rows of people were working at sewing machines, and I mean, it was not exactly a sweatshop. It was well lit, ventilated, whatever. But then the guy took me upstairs and started pulling out silk scarves and showing them to me one by one. And some of them were kind of nice. But then he said, "So which ones of these are you interested in?" And I said, "Really, none of them." And he said, "Well, why did you come here?" And I said, "Because my driver said I should, I wanted to go back to the hotel, and my driver said I should come here." And he said, "So you're not buying anything?" And I said, "Well, probably not." He said, "Okay, goodbye." So there was a different sort of experience, but then I went back to the cab, and like, okay, well, he said goodbye, so I guess it's back to the hotel for me now for a 50 rupee discount. And then we drove back in the rain. And the little auto rickshaw car splashed us and it got me in the face. But that's a different story. So, in short, the Vamp Willow approach works, but the splitting the commission works, but it's a waste of time. I mean, certainly I saved 50 rupees, which is a little over one U.S. dollar for sitting in a garment factory and having silk scarves handed to me one by one. So that's Jaipur. I recommend it. Good city to visit.